So, good morning. We are live with the Powerman ITU World Championships Duathlon 2016 for the 28th time in, well, the Duathlon capital of the world, Zofingen, the biggest city when it comes to Duathlon. The women are lining up for the start. And here we have today's start list for the women's race. Emma Pooley, the defending champion for Great Britain, two-time winner in the last 2 years, with Susanna Svensson and the Swiss Nina Brenn as the other main candidates. We'll be also looking out for Miriam van Rijen with number 5. The Dutch woman, first-timer Deborah Geslen. Martina Krembel, always very strong for Switzerland. We just saw Stefan Roof, president of the local organization committee. Katrin Ezefeld for Germany is also a woman who was always strong, certainly during the first run, but we're expecting more from Julia Vielener. Guten Morgen auch für alle Deutschsprachigen. Guten Morgen aus Zofingen. Wir sind wieder da für der 28. Mal Weltmeisterschaften Duathlon Powerman ITU. Susanna Svensson, looking good as always, just like Martina Krembel. Focus in the last minutes to the start. To the left, Emma Pooley. And first timer, Sawada from Japan. 2 minutes away from the starting line. We're experiencing it all live today. We're all over the world, with China for the first time enjoying our live broadcast. Great conditions for racing. We'll be starting in a few moments for the 10K run, followed by 150K on the bike. And then we will end with another 30K run, the hardest part, as they say, all the athletes in the World Championships. Temperature right now already 17, 18 degrees and rising. We're expecting a temperature that will go up to 26 degrees Celsius today. The best conditions we had in Zofingen since years. Emma Pooley will be enjoying it. She's used to Swiss weather conditions. She lives in Switzerland most of the time in the region of Zurich. And look at Susanna Smiling Svensson, that's her nickname, and always in for a good atmosphere. Cheering the crowd on. It's almost 8 o'clock, first start of the day. At 9 o'clock we will have the men who will be starting their race. And there they are, all 12 elite women athletes. With first-timer Deborah Geslen for Belgium, next to her Miriam van Rijen for the Netherlands. She has had a very good Powerman season. And they're off. The World Championships Duathlon Powerman ITU have started, with, as you can see in the age group field, a lot of British ladies. The sport is very big in Great Britain, but also in Switzerland, in Germany. We'll be seeing a lot more age groupers from those two countries. during the day. Certainly very large number of Swiss athletes in the open Powerman race. Last year we didn't see much of an attack in the first few kilometers in the women's race. The more experienced athletes know that the first run is more a warm-up, but still they can hurt each other. And at the end of the 10K, they will try to gain some advantage to get into the transition area first. Also der Start zum Frauenweltmeisterschaften 2016 ITU Powerman Duathlon mit Emma Pooley, zweifacher Siegerwinner in Zofingen. Und gut um Julia Filena mit dran zu sehen. It's a tough start. The first few kilometers directly uphill. And it's Julia Fielener for Germany who is setting the pace with Emma Pooley and Nina Brenn with a few meters advantage to the group. That's led by Martina Krembühl and Miriam Varea. It's not the biggest women's field we had in Zofingen, but it's a very strong field. And last year we saw that Emma Pooley is not invincible. She did run towards a second world title. But if you remember what happened last year in that last lap, where on the trail in the woods, she came to a standstill, all cramped up, had to lower the pace and then ran towards victory, but it was not like 2014 when she was outstanding, when she broke the course record. The Swiss media, in particular Esther, about that course record, if she was planning to break it today, and she's definitely gonna have a go. So let's see. And Julia Fielener was setting the pace, but it's Emma Pooley who is now taking the lead, and looks like Fielener is struggling a bit at the last uphill section there, where we will enter the first off-road part, always very tough. And the gap is increasing. So definitely a different tactics from Emma Pooley than last year, when they were still together with a big group of about 7-8. Fielener, who tries to keep up now with Pooley and Nina Brenn. And if you're joining us on the YouTube live stream from Powerman Zofingen, feel free to comment on everything you see. Let's make it an interactive day. It's going to be a long day, but we're here at the finish line with a great view. And let's look again at the start. A big pack in the women's race. And we're expecting a big battle today, certainly on the bike. Emma Pooley, who is a renowned former cyclist now, but who has proven the last 2 years that she's also a very strong runner. The women on their way for the first run, 10K on the beautiful course of Zofingen. Still Emma Pooley in the lead with Nina Brenn, and yes, Julia Fielener has dropped off. She made an effort to get back to the two leaders, but Emma Pooley is looking very strong today. Now, experts say that the duathlon here in Zofingen really starts after 100K on the bike. We have seen some pretty fast runs in the past, but not always with a successful result afterwards. But Emma Pooley is here for the third time, and she certainly knows what she's doing. So we expect Emma Pooley to have a great race again here. And she knows, of course, that there are some other strong runners in the pack. Good to see Nina Brenn in the front of the race. Nina, who combines duathlon with triathlon. Last week, she won the half triathlon in Bregenz, in Austria, the Trans Vorarlberg Triathlon. Nina Brenn aus der Schweiz gewann der Trans Vorarlberg Triathlon für eine Woche in Bregenz, in Österreich. She's also a former winner of the Inferno Triathlon, five-time winner of the Extreme Swiss Triathlon, so a very experienced athlete who had her biggest race this year in Copenhagen, when she became European champion, also with a very fast run. And last year in her first ITU long distance world championships here in Zofingen, she took the fifth place. So Nina Brenn is a force to be reckoned with. Emma Pooley knows it and is right at her feet. And it looks like they're having a nice gap on Julia Fielener. And we also need to look out what the gap will be to the chase back with Susanna Svensson, with Miriam van Rijen, with Katrin Ezeveld. Names that you will be hearing throughout the day. We have about 5 to 6 top favorites. Of course, we're excited to see our Japanese woman here in her first World Championships. This looks like a great start by Emma Pooley and Nina Brenn. We weren't expecting it, but good to see them racing close together and turning the heat up. And look at Emma Pooley, looking behind her. She definitely has a plan today. Emma Pooley can succeed to make both the British fans and the Swiss fans happy, because you can say she's half Swiss. She has been living for a few years now near Zurich.
Willkommen hier in Zofingen, Powerman Duathlon 2016. 11 Minuten sind die Frauen bereits unterwegs und zu sehen hier ab und
there's a downhill section.
Nina Brenn und Emma Pooley.
You can see that Nina Brennwell, she has the experience from the Inferno Triathlon, but also from other mountain running races.
Ja, das ist ein spannendes, sehr spannendes Duell, weil Nina Brenn ist ja die aktuelle Europameisterin und Emma Pooley ist die aktuelle Weltmeisterin. Also,
so the European Champion in a direct battle with the World Champion. Both are now used to winning gold medals.
Emma Pooley ist ja sicher eine ganz starke Radfahrerin, weil sie war auch wieder in Rio an den Olympischen Spielen dabei und hat dort das Einzelzeitfahren auf Rang 14 beendet und das Straßenrennen auf Rang 53.
Ja, wir möchten gleich die Gelegenheit.
While we are looking at the two leading women, we can tell you that with the live links from Tractalis, we have also a new feature here in Zofingen this year, GPS tracking for the athletes, so you can follow them where they are on the course. Also gives you a great overview of what the run course and later on the bike course looks like. You can find it all via the website powerman.ch and look at Nina Brenn. Technically perfect, the downhill on this off-road part of the first run course, 10K.
Und da die Damen jetzt gerade auf den ersten Kilometer unterwegs sind, gilt auch ein herzlicher Dank dem Kilometersponsor für Kilometer 1, Martin Behnd aus Oftringen, www.rb-cs.ch. Kilometer 2 durch Robbie Urban aus Zofingen. Buchen Sie Ihre unvergessliche Skifahrt mit Kapitän Robbie, www.cs-robbie.ch. Kilometer 3, gesponsert von Daniel Münden, Informatik AG aus Glashütte, zuverlässige Partner für SAP-Dienstleistungen, www.dmi-ag.ch. Und Kilometer 4, durch Armin Rund, Gesundheitszentrum aus Furtenwald.
Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley running in the sun. Not something we're used to see here. For me, it's the seventh time in Zofingen, fifth time that we're bringing live commentary through the internet for the live stream. And we've never had conditions like this. Still, the weather forecast shows possible signs of rain showers during the day, but not too much, with a temperature which will go up to 26 degrees. And that could be a deciding factor, certainly on the bike, 150K in the sun. What a great start by Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley. They're giving it all in the first 15 minutes of their race.
Wo wir die Zielankünfte geplant haben. Aber jetzt die erste Passage der Damen schon bald hier bei uns in der.
And they're on their way at the end of their first lap towards the stadium. And the noise will go up. Still a lot of men around us here who are preparing their bikes in the transition area. We just saw Diego van Looy making some last-minute adjustments, one of the outsiders for Belgium later on. The men will start their race at 9 o'clock. So a 1 hour difference between the women and the men. Here they come, Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley with a comfortable lead, it looks.
In a couple of seconds, they will be here in the transition area.
Die zwei ersten Damen, Nina Brenn für der Schweiz und Emma Pooley für Großbritannien, auf dem Weg zum Arena.
Please welcome back in the transition area, Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley.
And there they enter the arena. Nina Brenn and of course all the Swiss supporters now at the grandstands applauding her. Great start by the European champion. And as you will see, it's a new run course through the arena next to the athlete tent. So they're making two circles to describe it in the Finnish stadium. Nina Brenn in the lead. The crowd already going wild now. Here they come, Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley, and then we're on the lookout for Susanna Svensson, who has overtaken Katrin Ezefeld, Miriam van Rijen in fourth place, and Martina Krembel. The gap is 40 seconds. Susanna Svensson looking good. Miriam van Rijen right behind her, and then a few meters from the Danish and the Dutch lady, we see Martina Krembel. Susanna smiling Svensson. She has a love-hate relationship with Zofingen, but last year was very happy with her podium finish. Miriam van Rijen had a great season, inexperienced here in Zofingen. Martina Krembel and Katrin Ezefeld. So where is Julia Vielener? Well, she has entered the stadium, the arena, 1 minute behind the 2 liters, Guts and Steiger for Switzerland. And here she is, Julia Vielener, all dropped way back. And we just saw her passing our commentary position, and she's not looking really good. Was ist los mit die Julia Vielener? War da mit Nina Brenn und Emma Pooley. Aber nur mal im 9. Platz. Rückstand von 1 Minute 14. Und das sah nicht gut aus, wenn sie uns hier passierte. Julia Vielener, 9. Platz. Monique Großrieder war im 10. Platz. Dann haben wir Deborah Gesselen und Iris Zavala. The first age group women are passing by. Here we see Zavada. Her very first world championships. Good to see an elite athlete from Japan. Annette Corridon, of course, Annette Corridon in the front of the age group race. It's always a shame not to see her racing as an elite athlete. She's done quite some great Powerman racing. But we're looking again at the two leading women, Nina Brenn for Switzerland, Emma Pooley for Great Britain. Shoulder to shoulder running with a gap of 46 seconds.
Back off the first lap. We'll see the next athletes here. 20 minutes.
Manuela Knispel for Team USA just passed us. Good morning to Ken Foster, watching from Arizona. And thanks guys for the comments on our YouTube page. That's why we do it. a live commentary all day long up until 4 o'clock this afternoon. So you will be live with us with all the finishes and all the race. We just saw Julia Ecker passing us here at the finish line, but we are looking at a beautiful sight. Nina Bren, the European champion, shoulder to shoulder to the world champion, Emma Pulley. So feel free to join us on the live stream on YouTube. You can find all the links at the powerman.ch website from Powerman Zofingen. 28th time in the capital of worldwide duathlon. This is the biggest race of the world. This is the biggest race of the year. And these two, they know it. Nina Bren for Switzerland and Emma Pulley for Great Britain. In what already is a big race from the two champions. The gap was 46 seconds to Susanna Svensson and Miriam van Rijen when they left the arena, the center part of the World Championships. Martina Kreenbul was in fifth at 51 seconds. Katrin Ezeveld in sixth, 56 seconds behind. And then we had Bettina Steiger and Katrin Gutz, 1 minute 10. And then Julia Fielener, who was in front with these two women, but who has dropped the pace. Maybe she's looking for her own pace. It's always the best thing to do when you're not feeling the run legs like you normally do. So let's hope that Julia Fielener can find that pace and then get back to the front of the race. She was one of our race favorites today. Maybe had a start a bit too fast. We'll see that later on. Like I said before, experts say that you can't tell anything about the Zofingen race before the first 100k on the bike. So after 110k of racing, it becomes clear who will be in the battle for the medals, for the podium places. And this race in Zofingen, it's something else. It's the only duathlon on the ITU level and in the Powerman series with the ultra long distances, a 10k run, 150k on the bike and 30k on the final run. Most Powerman races have a 10k run, 60k bike and another 10k run. And IPA, the International Powerman Association, is planning on organizing world championships for that medium distance. We saw Solis in the arena. That's the leader in the para duathletes competition. Always good to see him. He was smiling at us. And he just passed the same arena where we saw a few minutes ago Nina Bren and Emma Pulley. Sexelby and Pryor have just passed us, and now we are looking at Travadon for France, David Travadon in the para-duathletes competition in the stadium. 45 seconds, that was the gap towards Susanna Svensson and Miriam van Rijen. And look at the face of Miriam, she's feeling good. Susanna always looks like she's giving her all, but that's the way she races. And Martina Kreenbul. Katrin Ezeveld has been racing Powerman, well, for as long as we know. We've been into Powerman racing for about 15, 20 years. And can't remember a race without Katrin Ezeveld. She's always been there. Good to see her. We just saw our ITU technical delegate, Paul Gross, who informed us that Rafael, our Spanish paratriathlete, competed at the national championships for paratriathletes in Banyoles, where the European championships for teams were held. He won the bronze medal, then took an overnight flight and started this morning here. That's what Powerman racing is all about. These two did not need to take a flight. Emma Pooley, living in Switzerland, and Nina Brenn, also from Switzerland, doing great in the first run.
Rosemary Tartander from Great Britain, welcome back from the transition zone, and all sie unterstützen sie. Offenbach holt die zweite Laufrunde auf die zweite 5 Kilometer.
What's also a nice thing to know about these two is that they can celebrate their birthdays together. Emma Pooley celebrating her birthday the 3rd of October. Nina Brenn will be having her birthday the 4th of October, so they can have a party together. And from the looks of it, it could be a medal party. Nina Brenn will be 37 years old in October. Emma Pooley reaches the age of 34. Die zwei ersten Damen, Nina Brenn und Emma Pooley. Sie haben Geburtstag im Oktober. Der 3. Oktober gibt es Emma Pooley. Sie wird 34. Und der 4. Oktober, einen Tag später, haben wir Nina Brenn zum 37. Geburtstag. And the Powerman organization asked Nina Brenn what her goal was for Zofingen 2016. She said, well, not leaving the track. She was not thinking about any possible place on the podium, but she wants to have a good race. And not leaving the track means she wants to avoid having a fall. She had a terrible fall off the bike in the end of May. Still has some back pain, but most of the injuries have healed.
Für Kilometer 8, Kilometer 9 wird gesponsert von Schenkel Hydraulik AG aus Erlinsbach und Kilometer 10 von Atraxel Fruchtimporte AG, neu in Pfaffenau stationiert, Früchte, Gemüse und Tiefkühlprodukte. Stephanie Harder, welcome in the transition zone. She's moving on to our second lap.
So,
während das machen wir uns bereit. Und nach 30 Minuten haben wir sie bereits wieder bei uns zurück in der Werkstation. Ihr seht sie jetzt bereits.
So we're already a half hour into the World Championships. If you just joined us, welcome in the beautiful city of Zofingen. Good to see Sandra Verlinde rooting for her local hero Andy Sutz. United States, I guess she also will be rooting for this Nina Bren and Emma Pooley. What a great race from both ladies. And that sieht sehr gut aus. Für Nina Bren und Emma Pooley. Noch 1 Kilometer zum Wechselzone. Last kilometer towards the arena, towards the transition area, where they will mount a bike for 150k. They're back on the road, left the off-road track, which is always a very difficult ingredient for most of the athletes, but not for Nina Bren and Emma Pooley. And still a very high pace. Look at the cadence. Sarah Looney. It looks like a copy when you see them running. Same pace, same cadence, almost same leg height as well. And let's see how much Emma Pooley has recovered from a tough race in Rio, where she raced the Olympic road race in support of Lizzie Armistead. Luckily she stayed on the bike because we saw some terrible falls in Rio. But here she is, about 1 month later, competing for gold with the reigning European champion Nina Bren. And Emma Pooley on their way to the transition area, and it looks like the gap has increased further. The long downhill section towards the arena. Nina Bren, who is taking the lead most of the time, could be a bit of psychological warfare, although the women are always friendly towards each other. Great atmosphere also before the start, we noticed. And Nina Bren and Emma Pooley know each other, of course. Both were here last year. Emma Pooley, you know the story. She took her second World Championship gold medal. Nina Bren finished in fifth place after a good race. But looks like she's ready to step it up a notch. Come on, Nina. Nina Bren and Emma Pooley on their way to the transition area. Die zwei Damen an die Spitze auf dem Weg zum Arena, zum Wechselzone. There they come, entering the arena. Nina Bren and Emma Pooley with a very fast first run. 35 minutes 30 seconds. That's a really fast pace. Nina Brenn still in front. And again, the crowd going wild. It's still early in Zofingen, but the sun is out. And the crowd is out to watch the starts and to watch the transition for the women. Who are in their run loop in the middle of the arena. Good to see. New setup here at the finish. There she comes, on her way to transition. Nina Brenn for Switzerland, Emma Poli for Team GB. The two leaders. Let's see who has the fastest transition. But my bet is that they will try to stay together. Nina Brenn, very fast transition. There she goes, on her way to 150K on the bike. And Emma Poli. Number one, the defending champion, in second place. And now we're waiting for the first runner-up. Let's see if it still will be Susanna Svensson. She was in third place, right behind the two race leaders. But what a run. Yeah, there she comes. 37 minutes, 13 seconds. Susanna Svensson entering the arena. Transition time, 36:57 for Nina Brenn. 10 seconds behind her, Emma Poli on the bike for 150K. And now Susanna Svensson, and she's on her own. So she has dropped Miriam Varejen, who is about 25 seconds back, together with Martina Krembel, followed by Katrine Ezefeld. But here we are looking at Susanna Smiling Svensson, who has had some great races this year. Almost all of them podium finishes. Just once silver in the Powerman, in Ulm, the new Powerman in Germany. Susanna Svensson, dritter Platz. One minute 42 is the gap. 1:42. Die Rückstand für Susanna Svensson. Hier hebben we Miriam van Rijen. Dan schakelen we heel even over op Nederlands. Voor de sterke Nederlandse atleten. Ook zij is iemand om rekening mee te houden. Kijken hoe ze die 150 kilometer fietsen gaat verteren. 2 minuten 8, de achterstand. 2 minutes 8 seconds, the gap for Miriam Varejo with a very fast transition. We saw Katrien Ezefeld getting ready for transition. And here is Martina Krembel. She was 2 minutes 8 seconds behind the two leaders in the stadium. But this looks to be a big group in pursuit of the two leading ladies. Katrien Ezefeld now on the bike. Here we see Bettina Steiger. And this is Katrien Guts. Also Monique Grossrieder. Die drei Frauen für der Schweiz. Guts. Katrien Guts. Auf dem Weg für 150 Kilometer auf dem Fahrrad. Dann haben wir hier Bettina Steiger aus Maisbach. Und hier geht Monique Grossrieder aus Düdingen. You see some other bikes stacked up for two deputies. Deborah Gesselin for Belgium. And Airi Sawada from Sapporo, Japan. They're also on their way now in the transition area. We see them in the final loop. Deborah Gesselin looks behind her, sees Airi Sawada. The gap is 4 minutes 16. And no more signs of Julia Fehlener. Looks like she's out of the race. But first, let's look at the transition. Deborah Gessler and Ayri Sawada. Followed by Annette Corridon. But in front of Annette was another age group athlete. And I think that was in the open category. Yep. Flora College is leading the open category. So Gesselin and Sawada on the bike. Or Nina Brennen is already looking good. The Swiss leading athlete doing great. For our Danish supporters who are viewing this live stream, Annette Corridon is the first ITU age group lady now on the bike. She just exited the transition area. Nina Brenn, that sieht sehr gut aus. Yes, the kilometers off the Argon 18. She's made a lot of progress. That's clear. Even meegeven voor de Nederlandse fans die kijken. Anne Hobbelt komt hier in de wisselzone binnen in tweede positie in de open categorie. We have the ITU races where they are contending for the medals. But there's also the open category for Powerman athletes who are racing in their team or club colors and not in the national team outfits. And we will also be on the lookout for the positions there. And you can see Emma Pooley making up time. She was 10 seconds behind after transition, but she already closed the gap and now taking her time to have a first bite. Eating, I think it's a gel or maybe a protein bar. Very important part of long distance racing in both triathlon and duathlon. Nutrition is of the biggest importance, because if you run out of energy, you run out of legs, and that will be the end of the race. Talking about the end of the race, we briefly mentioned it here in the transition area that we've lost Julia Fehlener, one of the race favorites, is out. So sorry. She was in the front together with Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley. I already thought that I saw her limping a bit in the off-road downhill section. So maybe she got injured. But the fact is that Julia Fehlener has dropped out of the race. Great aerodynamic position from Nina Brenn. At least 10 meters behind her is Emma Pooley. As you might know, long distance race means no drafting. So they can't enjoy the draft from the riders in front of them. And they need to maintain a gap of at least 10 meters. And when they overtake, they need to do it in a few seconds, otherwise they need to drop back into their former position. We'll have referees on the course who will be checking out if all the athletes play it fair, otherwise they will be placed in the sin bin, the penalty box at the end of each bike lap. Emma Poli on the time trial bike. Something different again for her. Well, she was, of course, a silver medalist in Beijing in 2008 in the time trial race in Beijing at the Olympics. This year she was in Rio in support of Lizzie Armitstead in the Olympic road race. So this means another switch from the road bike to the TT bike, but she's used to both. Two years ago we got to know her as a great cyclist, but we have also learned that she can run really, really fast. And it's good to see so many of you watching our live stream today. So good morning to all of you. Great that you're joining us. Leave your comments on the YouTube page. Maybe we will get back on it. Let's make it an interactive day. Here in Zofingen, it's a great day for it. We're trying to give you a bit of a feel of what it looks like here, what it feels like in the sun. And as you can see, the first section of the bike course already has its uphill moments. The big climb will follow later on. The Bodenberg is the highest point of the 50k bike lap.
Eine sehr schöne Laufstrecke, sehr spannende für alle Zuschauer, sehr spannende Laufstrecke, indem sie schneckenförmig auf dem Heitern sich ineinander wieder auseinanderwinden. Also, wenn
sie okay, Sandra Verlinde, goedemorgen. We hebben het daar net al in het Engels gezegd. Nu ook in het Nederlands. We'll be doing this live commentary in four languages. Main language will be English, but from time to time we will switch to German, to Dutch, and to French. Later on in the men's race we will be talking a lot more in French. Bonjour pour tout le monde en France et pour tous les autres francophones qui nous suivent pour ce live stream en direct de Zofingen dans la Suisse pour les championnats du monde duathlon longue distance. Mais j'ai pas des bonnes nouvelles pour les supporters français, parce que le grand favori, le champion du monde Gaël Le Bellec, il a blessé, il a annulé pour aujourd'hui. Je regarde à droite ici dans la zone de transition et je vois un espace vide avec le numéro 1. Pas de vélo dans le parc à vélo pour Gaël Le Bellec. Ça veut dire que Sepp Oden sera le grand favori. So I'm just saying in French that we don't have the defending champion with us. Gaël Le Bellec had to drop out due to an injury, which is unfortunate because he was all set to win a third consecutive time here in Switzerland. So no world champion in the men's race, which means that all eyes will be on the Belgian Seppe Oden, who was second in the European Championships in Copenhagen this year. But since then has been racing more in triathlon than in duathlon. And the Danish supporters will be on the lookout for Søren Bistrup, who will be presenting the men in a few moments. They're less than 10 minutes away from their start. But in the meantime, enjoy a great race by Nina Bren, still in the lead, with right behind her the defending champion Emma Poli. And Nina Bren looks like she has the legs today. Does she has what it takes to win it? Due to the fall in May, she didn't have a lot of competition races, and only picked up training since a few weeks. Here we just saw Søren Bistrup going into the front of the starting area. Thomas Bruns is also there. He's a Dutch from birth, but he's been living for a long time now in Australia. Speaks better Australian English than Dutch. Then we have Diego van Looy, one of the outsiders. He has had two first Ironman races this year and did great in both of them. Et peut-être on peut attendre quelque chose du athlète de la France, Yannick Cadalin. Michele Parone for Liechtenstein on his way to the starting line. And Mark Widmer, always a force to be reckoned with here in Zofingen. He's here, Daniel Formela. We haven't seen him racing a lot. We haven't heard from him in a long time, but he surprised us last year with a podium finish, silver medal in the European Championships in Horst. Thibaut Humbert pour la France. Et Thibaut Lecra. Deux athlètes qui sont ici pour la toute première fois. Félix Köhler and Mike Schifferle. Und da ist er. Wieder in Zofingen. Andy Sütz. Good luck, Andy. It's great to see him racing again. Fabian Sender, always very strong. And good to see so many Swiss athletes lining up in the elite race, like Rolf Wermelinger. And Swiss Duathlon, who is having a new boost. Thomas Rusch. We like the hair, we like the cap. Maxim Kuzmin, we don't know much about him. Martin, also having a good season, mostly on the short distance races. Marigueta for Portugal, making his way to the starting line. And here, Pierluigi Senor for Italy. Also the Gianno Favaron on the first starting line. Alex Lamberix to the left. Alex, the Nederlandse Zwitser, woont al een hele tijd in Zwitserland. En daar staat het startveld bij de mannen met Seppe Oden als grote favoriet vandaag. Hier hebben we de startlijst. This is the start list with Seppe Oden, Søren Bistrup en Thomas Bruns. Diego van Looy is one of the outsiders. Felix Köhler. Yannick Cadalin is also one of the race favorites. Michele Paone for Liechtenstein. Then Mark Widmer and Daniel Formela. I'm reckoning that Daniel Formela will play his part in today's race. And Thibaut Humbert, let's see what he can do for a new French team with Thibaut Lecras, Yannick Cadalens, of course, somebody we already know. And look at this big race. Schifferle, Suts, Zeender, Bieler, Wermelinger and Roush. Six athletes out of the Schweiz.
Good luck on the biking course for Lee Wieser.
And Sebastian Retzlaff, natürlich.
Cora Sturzel and Shelly Irvine.
Für Deutschland. Søren Bistrup. He's been on the podium before. Last year in third place. Errechnet ein erneuter Podestplatz, hoffentlich zu oberst. Thomas Burns, the winner of the Powerman Malaysia in Putrajaya. That's about the biggest duathlon in the world, if you look at the starting list there. Over 2,000 athletes, more than 2,000 athletes who take the start there. Cadalin, one of the strong runners. Diego Van Looy, who has been switching from duathlon to triathlon. He's pretty new in duathlon. Came from cycling, just like Seppel Oden. The kopman van de joggingclub van Herend. Was die aan het volgen zijn. We moesten van hen de groeten doen aan de Pierre. Dat is Pieter Hemerik. Humbert, Witmer en Paone. Men who can also play an important role. Certainly Mark Witmer. Focus. Tension that's rising. Fabian Zeender is keeping warm on the second row. And not many athletes who have chosen to wear compress socks and tubes, maybe due to the weather conditions, like I said before.
And the next woman in the transition area, Rosemary Chalthunter from Great Britain. Well done.
Morning to SD. And no, we're not a bloody cask up. Good to see so much interaction on the YouTube live stream. Stay with us all day. We will be here until 4 p.m. this afternoon to witness it live. The 2016 Powerman ITU Long Distance Duathlon World Championships, less than 30 seconds to the start. The crowd is ready, we are ready, the athletes are ready for a great race. They will start with a 10K run, two laps, with a big elite field, one of the biggest of the last years. A lot of Swiss athletes in there, headed by Mark Witmer. The two Belgians, the French, with four athletes, the Danish. This is going to be a great race. And they're off. We saw Jan Meesmans passing, former age group world champion. A lot of Team GB and Team USA athletes with Stroop, with Hughes, with Hardy. These are the men under 50 years old, because the men plus 50 started together with the women, or just behind the women. Did you see Seppel then looking at the curler, thinking, hey, are you one of the favorites? No, okay, you can go. Head start from Köhler for Germany. So Felix Köhler, a German athlete who lives in Basel, pretty close to Zofingen, it's about 30 minutes drive. He is opening up the first run, but the rest of the field is looking at him. Seppel then checking his watch to see what the pace is. Looks to be happy with it. And then Martin next to him. Yeah, he needs to control himself. Pablo Martin Lopez from Madrid has had some great racing in short distance, but he has been warned at on Zofingen 190Ks, of which 40K are running, and something else. So, Felix Köhler an die Spitze. In the erste Meter, 10 Kilometer auf die Laufstrecke, zwei Runden nach 16, 17 Minuten erwarten wir die erste Duathleten hier im Arena für die zweite Runde. Felix Köhler aus Deutschland. Aber er wohnt in Basel. Das ist eine halbe Stunde von der Strecke hier in Zofingen. That's the great thing about Zofingen. It's the biggest duathlon city in the world, of course. After 28 years, 28 editions of Powerman races, 9 times ITU World Championships. But it's also very close to the German border, it's close to the French border. The Italians and the Austrians do not need to travel far. And even from the Netherlands and Belgium, it's within reach. Takes about 8-9 hours to get there, depending on which part of the country you're coming. So the race attracts athletes from a lot of countries. 28 countries, to be exact. Felix Köhler opening up a gap towards the rest of the field. And a bit of a surprise, this Felix Köhler, but we have seen it before in the past. So no worries yet for the race favorites. They know what to expect from a long day in Switzerland. Köhler was renowned, of course, for his running. He switched from running to duathlon. We see it more and more. Duathlon becoming again pretty popular, certainly in Germany and in Switzerland. Germany now hosting 2 Powerman races. Also, Switzerland will get a new Powerman race. That's also big news. Next year, a medium distance Powerman race in Switzerland. What a great field. The men's race on their way for a 10K run. We'll be live with you all day here from the beautiful city of Zofingen.
Short information from the info point. There is a pass board which has been brought to the info point, which has been found, and it belongs to Bugaru Maria. Bugaru Maria.
And there we saw the attack by Felix Köhler.
Right now, when you're missing your passport, please move on to that info point in the Powerman Maria where you can get your passport back. Thank you.
He's still in the lead.
Ja, meine Damen und Herren, schauen Sie mal auf den Bildschirm und da sehen Sie Felix Köhler rennen, wie er kurz vor dem Ziel wäre. Also Felix Köhler mit einer unglaublichen Pace, die er hier gleich loslegt auf den ersten Kilometern. Das Herrenrennen ist gerade mal 6 Minuten 20 Sekunden alt und er versucht hier gleich die Athleten unter Druck zu setzen. Felix Köhler auch bereits der Sieger der Duathlon-Serie.
Yeah, Köhler. Somebody from the short distance has switched from running to Duathlon and has won a lot of running races. But this year was victorious in the Swiss Duathlon series. So let's see what he can do on this long distance course. It's the first time for him.
Das ganz ein guter Mann unterwegs und bereits in front alleine Felix Köhler.
He is of course a former world champion. In the men 30 category last year. So he knows how tough it is here in Zofingen. But still now racing as an elite athlete at something else. Last year he ran 30 minutes 14 seconds in the first run, but then dropped back a bit on the bike and then had a very good second run as well. So this is Felix Köhler, Duathlon Weltmeister letztes Jahr in der Klasse M30. Nach der ersten Laufetappe über 10 Kilometer hat er eine fantastische Zeit von 30 Minuten 14. Nach das Radfahren war er auf Rang 6. Könnte noch Platzen gut machen und gewann die Goldmedaillen in der Klasse M30. Aber heute zum ersten Mal im Elite-Race, ja, das wird etwas ganz anderes sein, aber ja. Vielleicht gibt es hier einen guten Tag für Felix Köhler. It's a great start from the German athlete.
Sponsoren wie auch den beiden Sponsoren unseren Kilometer, wie AH Shop Fittings AG Best Product Presentation, Laden Richtung den Real Second. Für Kilometer 11, dann Bay & Partner Immobilien GmbH, für Kilometer 12, Bär Kleintransport und Kurierdienste. Kilometer 13, Malgeschäft Roger Weishaupt aus Kassow und Obergösgen, dann Kilometer 14, auf ALV Fenstertechnik AG in Zofingen, haben Sie Ihre Fenster im Griff. Kilometer 15, herzlichen Dank.
And he's already in the downhill section, making his way towards the arena.
Langsam aber sicher sind natürlich auch die Short-Distance-Athleten. Also am einen Richten sind sie schon lange und etwa in einer halben Stunde gut geht es dann auch für sie auf die Strecke. Auch hier der Hinweis, die Wechselzone wird dann irgendwann einmal geschlossen. Also ihr könnt nicht bis um eine Minute vor dem Start hier in der Wechselzone sein. Ihr werdet dann darauf aufmerksam gemacht von den Offiziellen, aber bitte haltet das im Hinterkopf, die Wechselzone bleibt nicht bis an den Start hin offen.
Der weitere Programmpunkt, wie Michael erwähnt hat, dann mit den...
And it looks like a nice gap for the German Felix Köhler.
Der Frauen und 10 vor 10 der Männer inklusive der Staffeln. Vorher haben wir auch noch die Langdistanzstaffeln, die um 9.
A swim voice coach is asking why Lebelec is not on the start line. We briefly explained just before the start that he is injured. So injury for Gael Lebelec, and he had to drop out last minute from the race.
Welcome back to the transition zone, Rebecca Young from the United States Arlington. Welcome back after the first 10k run, and she's now getting prepared for her 150k bike. And
Sandra van Linden was asking if we have any indications on the pace from this leader
Sunday morning
for Germany.
Everybody.
Well, last year he had a 30-minute run in the first 10K. It looks like he's repeating himself. No indication from the current pace, but we will see that in a few minutes when he's entering the transition area. He's on his way, the downhill section towards the center of Zofingen. This is what Benny van Steeland used to call the toughest part of the race, an attack on the hamstrings, the steep downhill parts of the run course. There he comes. Felix Köhler.
Aber jetzt Konzentration und willkommen. Große Stimmung im Spitzenmarkt.
Darius into the arena. Dual race leader for Germany.
First man back in the transition zone. So get ready in the arena, Mr. Small.
Felix Köhler, the German athlete living in Switzerland from Basel. There will be some Swiss supporters as well for him. But the men in pursuit are not really far behind. Rolf Wermelinger with Fabian Zinder in the pursuit, 21 seconds the gap. First lap, 13 minutes 32. Well, at the end of the lap here, 14:22. What a time. Felix Köhler, Fabian Zinder, Rolf Wermelinger, Thibaut Lecras, Yannick Cadalin, Andy Zutz, Pablo Martin, Seppo Oden, Thomas Bruns, and Daniel Formela are all in the chase pack, some 20 seconds behind. And we see him passing here with Fabian Zinder, who is looking good. Wermelinger, Lecras, Cadalin, Seppo Oden, Thomas Bruns, who is trying to hang on. And here, Daniel Formela. Like I mentioned, one of the guys to look out for today. Søren Bistrup also looking very strong today, focused. Always searches his own pace in the first run. He knows that he's one of the best bikers out there. But he's one of those athletes who always has a better second run. Mark Widmer for Switzerland is 47 seconds behind, followed by Maxim Kuzmin for Russia. And then we see Thibaut Humbert, followed by Rui Narigueta for Portugal. They are 1 minute and 5 seconds behind our race leader, Diogo van Looy, at 1 minute 11. And Paone, Michele Paone for Liechtenstein.
Go, go, go!
Here we have Jan Meesmans. What a great start to the race. He's the first age group athlete, even in front of Pierluigi Senior, followed by Chris Roxburgh. Yeah, Chris Roxburgh, of course. He's in the front of the age group race, one of the strongest British athletes. And then we saw in third place, Brice Nesbitt from San Diego. Laurent Martineau pour la France en quatrième position dans les quatre groupes d'âge.
Patti, Mark Lawrence, Michael Ottagui, Sebastian Retzlaff, Christian Steinfeld, Lucius Boxler.
Jonas van der Vivere, die nog even een goede dag zei zelfs. Hoydenend Meisner voor Duitsland. En David Roef. But we're looking at our race leader. A gap of 20 seconds, Felix Köhler. But what a fast first lap from the German.
Go, 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 go!
Sebastian Retzlaff, looking good always. Finding his own pace. Diederik de Rijke for Belgium has just passed us here in the Finnish arena. While we are still looking at Felix Köhler, the world champion in the men 30 category last year. This year, for the first time in the elite race, together with all the big race favorites. There they are. You can see him at about 20, 25 seconds behind him.
Well,
maybe they want to keep an eye on this Felix Köhler, which means that all the other favorites are not really comfortable, giving him a too big a lead in the first run.
Tom Lawton, Marcus,
and this will hurt. Of course this will hurt. This big uphill section, certainly in the second lap. That's one of the hard things about Zofingen, about the World Championships, Duathlon ITU Powerman. The run courts never flat, it's always going up or going down.
From the first running part.
Same goes for the bike course, where we have laps of 50k. Felix Köhler is too fast for our technical delegates. It's great to see. And even for our race leader biker. So a fast uphill by the German athlete. Just to show you how fast he's running today. And now onto the off-road part of the course. Just a few moments to recover from the climb. Talking about climbing here, Emma Pulli, and in front Nina Brenn. So still together on this very tough long climb that they're on right now. Emma Pulli in front of her, Nina Brenn. They had a very fast first run. Opened up a gap of 1 minute 40 seconds to Susanna Svensson. And now our more than halfway through the first lap on the bike. Emma Pooley, who was not only racing the road race in Rio, but also had a great time trial, ranked 14th. 14th place for Emma. In the road race, she was 53rd, but she was there in support of Lizzie Armstead. And that's the hard part, of course, on the bike course, both of the women, most of the athletes on a time trial bike. And that's always a disadvantage on the uphill sections, but there are enough flat and downhill sections to gain the advantages of the triathlon TT bike. Nice cadence by Emma Pooley. Dancing on the pedals. Already 3 minutes 52, the gap towards Susanne Svensson, who is now biking in third place. Martina Krembul in fourth place. And then 4 minuts 46 behind them is Katrien Ezeveld. Miriam van Rijen dropped back to seventh place. She is 5 minutes 49 behind the two race leaders for the moment. But we are looking at our men race leader, Felix Köhler. Looking very strong today. But like I said before a few times, the World Championships, they will start about 110k into the race. After the second lap on the bike, then we can start crossing off who won't be in the medal race. And we can have a first go at predicting the medal winners. But Felix Köhler, for the time being, is having a great run. Also, das sieht gut aus für der Felix aus Deutschland. In der Powerman Arena bei der ersten Passage vom ersten Lauf. Die Rückstand für die Erfolger war 20 Sekunden nach dem ersten Runden. Und diese zwei still an die Spitze. Nina Brenn und Emma Pooley mit einem Rückstand von 3 Minuten 52 für Susanne Svensson und Martina Krembul. 4 Minuten 46 für Katrien Ezeveld, die deutsche Athletin Katrien Götz, mit einem Rückstand von 5 Minuten 26 und Miriam van Rijen aus den Niederlanden. 5 Minuten 49.
Dann weiteren Dank den Kilometersponsor, Kilometer 16, Emil Freya, Geauge Center 7, Lekua, Coaching, Schulung, Person, Persönlichkeitsentwicklung und Ausbildung zur Leben- und Trauerbegleitung.
Dann Ablauf Service GmbH Stadelbach, Hochdruckspülen, Kanalfernsehen, Dichtheitsprüfung, www.ablaufservice.ch.
Steiner Holzbau und Bedachungen aus Baustahl, www.steinerholzbau.ch für Kilometer.
It's great to see so many people commenting on the YouTube page. Keep it up. Stay with us all day or come back. We'll try to give updates around the hour of what happened and what you missed during that hour.
Beispiel problemlos 80 und mehr Stundenkilometer. Und Sie sehen da.
Nina Brenn, es passt. The top of the hill, and now in the downhill section. Good techniques. I just heard that she has been improving her bike skills. Always was a good climber. Otherwise, she wouldn't have won the Inferno Triathlon five times. Fünffache ihre Siegerin im Inferno Triathlon.
Ja, und zum weiteren Programm. 9:35
Und für eine Woche hat sie auch noch ein schwerer Halbtriathlon im Österreich gewonnen. Nina Brenn nach die Schütz gestürzt im Mai.
Leicht abfallenden Weg Richtung St. Urban. Also jetzt
und heute
richtig Tempo machen, richtig
ist sie wieder da.
Gefahren mit 40, 50 Stundenkilometer wird sie nach Richtung St. Urban unterwegs sein. Zum weiteren Programm 9:35 Uhr Long Distance Staffeln, dann 9:45 Uhr die Short Distance Athleten. Der Frauen starten 9:45 Uhr und 9:50 Uhr.
Felix Göder in the sun, looking great, briefly checking his pace, and it looks like he has increased the gap. He's looking good during this first 10k run, 27 minutes into his world championship race. Yep, the battle is on between the European champion Nina Brenn, who had a great race in Copenhagen. There was also a beautiful race in, well, similar conditions to today. It was also about 25, 26 degrees. The sun was out. A lot of people who were enjoying the sun around the running track and the bike track in the beautiful city of Copenhagen. It was good to see so many people enjoying the Powerman Duathlon in Denmark. Denmark, who has always been one of the important countries in Duathlon racing, just like Belgium, just like Switzerland and France. The Danish fans will be on the lookout for Susanna Svensson in the women race and Søren Bistrup in the men race. Søren Bistrup, who was in the chase pack or just behind the chase pack. Goedemorgen aan Jacke Petrol overigens. And Mason Vlogs, no Brownlee brothers in this race. Would be great to see them in a duathlon as well. They've done it as they were younger in the junior races. We haven't seen them competing in a duathlon for years now. Maybe one day they will return to it. Unfortunately, no British elite athletes in the World Championship race today. And there he is, our race leader of the week, zum Wechsel, Felix aus Basel. He both has German and Swiss fans. That's like Emma Pooley, the British who's been living in Zurich for some years now. He's been living right close to the track here in Zofingen, and he knows the bike course. He will be the first to enter the 150K long bike track. Three laps to the Bodenberg and back. Felix Köhler. What a run, 30 minutes 21, that's about the same pace as last year. Great to see him running so fast in his first Elite World Championships. The world champion in the men 30 category, now into the transition area. And yeah, we're still waiting for the first athletes in the chase pack. He's opened up a big gap. There they are now with Martin in front with the Cadalin still there. And then we see three Swiss athletes. So good to see Andy Sutz, Fabian Zehnder and Rolf Wermelinger in that pack, 47 seconds back. Sepp Olden and Thomas Bruns are right behind them. Thibaut Lecra, toujours là. And c'est Yannick Cadalin qui va entrer le parc à vélo en deuxième position pour la France, à 47 secondes de notre leader pour l'Allemagne, Felix Köhler. Cadalin en deuxième position, in third place, Andy Sutz. Dritter Platz für der Andy. It's great to see him back to racing. Has had two terrible years filled with injuries. Yeah, this is gonna be a great race with Rolf Wermelinger.
Oh yeah.
Let's see what the athlete from Belt can do. And Fabian Zehnder, he's been here before. Here he is, the race leader from last year, Sepp Olden. But then Guy Lebelec beat him in the final 30K run. Søren Bistrup. And a great run. Let's look at the time. Søren Bistrup is 1 minute 30 seconds behind. Sepp Olden, 1 minute one behind. And Maxim Kuzmin, yeah, had a good run. 1:31 the gap. Daniel Formela now into the transition. The guy from Poland. There you can see the times, Cadalin 43 seconds, Zehnder, Sutz and Wermelinger together. Pablo Martin at 53 seconds, then Thomas Bruns and Sepp Olden 1 minute behind. Felix Köhler. Mark Widmer is entering the arena. And behind them, Michele Paone. From Mauren. Et Thibaut Humbert. Un écart de 2 minutes 34 pour l'athlète de la France. Followed by Rui Narigueta. 2 minutes 45 seconds a gap to the Portuguese. We see two Belgians entering. It's Diego van Looy, one of the outsiders. Two times top 10 finish here in an Ironman triathlon this year. And right behind him is Jan Meesmans, who was on the lookout for his bike. And was entering together with Diego van Looy and almost entered the elite row to look for his bike. But now he has found the right spot. Great run from Søren Otten in the men 20 category. He's now also into the transition and second place in the age group race. And Chris Rexbro in third place, yeah. Noblesse oblige, they call it in French. Chris in the men 30 category. Jan Meesmans in the men 35 category. So three category leaders. There we have Bieler for Switzerland. Jonas van der Vivere was on the podium last year in his age group. In the men 25 category this year. Sebastian Retzlaff has entered the transition area and will be on his way to the bike soon.
Christoph Steuerthaler. And we warten kürze auf Sebastian Retzlaff and Mark Lawrence.
Followed by Mike Schifferle. There's Retzlaff. 5 minutes 37 behind is a fellow German athlete, Felix Köhler. 21. in the Wechselzone. Sebastian Retzlaff. Der größte Duathlon-Ambassadeur für Deutschland. Und er soll froh sein mit Felix Köhler an die Spitze. Da geht Sebastian. Aber wir schauen mal auf Nina Brenn und Emma Poli. Die zwei immer zusammen gehen nach das Ende der ersten Runde, erste Durchfahrt. Am General Gissonstraße. So we are looking at the two women still close together. Nina Brenn, and then 10, 15 meters behind her, Emma Poli. On their way now to the end of the first bike lap. With the General Gissonstraße, that's the central point here, right in front of the stadium. Felix Köhler taking the lead in the men's race. And Köhler is looking good on the bike. Has had some great races this year. Won the Swiss Duathlon Series 2016. Has won also some running races as well. Will 2016 be the year of Felix Köhler? Would be great to see a German athlete in the front claiming one of the medals here in Zofingen. We saw Rob Delimore leaving the transition area for New Zealand. Every year we have a few New Zealand athletes. Here we saw Sepp Oden throwing his Hoka 1-1s in the transition boxes. And we're looking at the transition boxes right next to us, and we see the shoes of Susanna Svensson outside of the box, and the referees are there. Hopefully that will be without consequences for her. a great image here. They are transferring the elite transition area with about 1-2 meters to give all the athletes some more space. But we're looking at Felix Köhler, who is on fire. The German athlete living in Basel. He's one of the regional de l'étape, as they call it in French. He has been training a lot on the bike course here, on the Bodenberg, the famous hill, which we are climbing for the 28th time. Not always the extreme long distances like today. Technical delegate Paul Gross, who was overseeing the actions in the transition area. Looks to be a good decision. We saw the age groupers struggling for space right next to the elite athletes, and we don't want to interfere that with the World Championship medal race today. Felix Köhler, who had a 30-minute run today again. 31:51 is transition time. That was the first run, including the transition to the TT Triathlon bike. And now still in the lead. The sound you hear right now next to me is the rebuilding of the transition area for the elite athletes. Not something we see every day, but I think it's a wise decision. We have a great spot this year. We're looking at the finish line right in front of us, right next to us on the right-hand side is the transition area, where still a lot of athletes are coming into transition. Becoming a bit cloudy. That feels like more usual. We've seen it every year here in Zofingen. Let's hope that we can stay dry all day.
Sind dies zum Beispiel Hugo Blum, Marc van Gorp, Daniel Luppi, Beat Flühler, Holger Behrens, Roger Huhn, Philipp Bierer, Andy Traubiger, Morgan Gray, Uwe Reitz, Uli Fischer, Basis Horde, Schild Mattes, Peter Schaffer, Beat Meyer und Oliver Ricci.
And we were just checking with Paul Gross. He just explained to us that they made some more space to make it more safe and fair for all the athletes here in the transition area. We saw Susanna Svensson's shoes outside of the box. So, well, everything they will use again goes into the box, but if they choose to switch their pair of running shoes, the shoes that they're not using staying outside of the box, and the pair that you're using goes in the box. So no problems, she's on the safe side, she's on the Svensson.
GPS sender ausgestattet und dieser kann abgehört
The women on the Bodenberg. Emma Pooley still in second place behind Nina Pren, who is really looking great today. It's a long, winding climb. Great images, by the way, that we're having live from the course. Perfect coverage by the Swiss television. We'll be going live between 2 p.m. and 4 p.m. Good to see international Duathlon being covered live by the national television here in Switzerland. And the Swiss will be looking out for Nina Brenn. So far, it seems she has the legs to step up a notch from last year's fifth place, maybe towards a podium finish. Too soon to tell, but for the moment it's looking good. And this Felix Güller is also looking good. Yeah. It's not the first time that we have seen an age group champion step up to the elite level. And he's still young. This Felix Güller won the men 30 category at an age where you can win the Powerman Zofingen. We haven't seen many winners younger than 30. We had a few exceptions, but mostly you need. For the fans of Jonas van der Weveren and other age group athletes who are following us on the live stream, we will be trying to give you updates during the race, like each year, with the age group standings. The images will center around and focus on the elite athletes, but you know us, we will be following all the action all day long here in Zofingen. And you can always follow the live tracking as well. Just go to the powerman.ch website, and there you will find all the links to the different live stream options. Still athletes entering the transition area, and also our first Steffel athlete passed us. That's the team competition called Staffel in German. And it's a good time to have something to eat after the first run, like Mr. Hardy is doing right here. Monty Hardy from Irving, USA. A lot of Team USA athletes, a lot of Team GB athletes as usual. Triathlon and Duathlon, really popular sports. But most of the most popular and best triathletes from Great Britain are racing international teams like Poissy, who won the European Club Championships yesterday, in Banyoles, in Spain. The British team was 17th or 18th. It was a mixed relay competition with two women and two men in each team. Here is all solo. We would love to see Matt Morehouse racing again. This is John Morehouse in the men 50 category. Matt Morehouse, who was one of the British elite athletes, has been promoting duathlon racing for Team GB. We haven't seen him in a while, just like Lee Piercy. So Matt and Lee, if you're watching, we're missing you guys. Hope to see you back to racing soon. Swim Voice Coach is expecting Nina and Emma for a close battle during today. Those two will for sure decide the first two spots, he says on our YouTube page. So feel free to join us, to comment on the live stream, to say what you think about the race. And you can do it in any language you want. Well, we only know four languages. We will be switching from time to time. We'll try also to give you updates on the hour, every hour, about what's been happening, so when you return you'll know what you have missed. But there's more than 250 people watching right now, so great having you aboard already so early on a Sunday morning. I hope it's as sunny where you are as here in Zofingen, although we have some clouds above us. And from time to time you will see age group athletes not wearing their national team outfits. Oh, that was a tough first run. Yeah, that was what I was trying to explain to you earlier on. The run course here in Zofingen is really difficult because you go uphill and downhill all the time, and it's an attack on your hamstrings. And then you need to switch from the run legs to the bike legs. Not always easy to do, like we see here with our German athletes. Michael Quotz from the Forde Triminators in the men 50 category. Still some bikes in the transition area. But here is Nina Brenn, and she is on her way back down to Zofingen, already nearing the center of this beautiful city in the north of Switzerland, really close to Basel, the hometown of our men race leader Felix Köhler. Here we see him, Felix Köhler, still in the lead. The gap was 43 seconds to Cadalin Seender Suits Wermelinger, and followed by Martin and Bruns. Great scenery on the bike track. Felix Gurlitt in a pretty typical triathlete position. Moving to the front of the bike saddle. I've had a bike fitting specialist who said, well, those saddles are made to cover your complete behind, so why not use it all the way? But a lot of athletes are more comfortable sliding up to the front of the saddle, putting more pressure on their arms to pull on them and gaining more speed like that. Everybody has his own technique. Felix Köhler. Like I said before, nutrition really important. So already drinking from his sports drinks bottle. Water bottle in front of him between his arms to keep the aerodynamic position. They're almost on their way to Zofingen. Nina and Emma. We saw somebody commenting on how somebody was commenting here on our YouTube page that they would love to see Emma Pooley and Emma Pallant racing. Emma Pallant, the world duathlon champion on the short course. I think Emma still, well, Emma Pallant still a bit too young. Pallant, who has been racing the last two seasons also in Belgium in the T3 series, as a more specialized. But she also had her first experiences in half-distance triathlon racing. So maybe we will see Emma Pallant in the future here in Zofingen. But let's give her some time. She's really young, but she's talented. So that would be great to see indeed in the future. Emma Pooley against Emma Pallant. But already great to see this German duathlete stepping up. Finally, we have a new Sebastian Retzlaff. First bike hill, we have a timing point where we can see how big the gap will be, but we are heading towards Zofingen with the two race leaders in the women race, Nina Brenn for Switzerland and Emma Pooley. If you have just joined us, welcome on this beautiful day in Zofingen, the capital of duathlon. World Championships, Powerman ITU Duathlon Long Course. We're already 2 hours underway with the women race. And here you see the two race leaders for Switzerland. It's Nina Brenn, the reigning European champion, and Emma Pooley. They were together in the first run of 10K with Julia Vielehner. Vielehner for Germany was setting a very fast pace during the first kilometers, but then had to drop off. And she is now out of the race. So for the German fans who are watching us right now, bad news from Julia Vielehner, who was one of the race favorites for the podium today. It looked like she was injured a bit. Tried to open a gap and then failed. Had to let these two women go. and fell back and didn't enter the transition area after the second run lap. And in the first bike lap now we have the two race leaders close together. Nina Brenn, who has stayed in the leader position all the time with Emma Pooley, just 1 month after her Olympic road race and her Olympic time trial race in Rio. She was 14th in the women time trial race, former medalist in Beijing, but switched to triathlon and duathlon. The gap towards Susanna Svensson was 3 minutes 52 at the first climb. Susanna Svensson was together with Swiss athlete Martina Krembel in fourth. Katrin Eseveld for Germany was in fifth place. Then we had Katrin Götz for Switzerland in sixth, already 5 minutes 26 seconds behind Miriam van Rijen, who was running in fourth place after the first run. Fell back to the seventh place, 5 minutes 49 behind the leaders. Then we had Monique Grossrieder in eighth place. Deborah Gessle in her first World Championships in ninth place, 7 minutes 52 behind the race leaders. And Bettina Steiger in 10th place at 8 minutes 10 seconds.
Cross actually the train bridge, the train station Zofingen, so they are just having the old town of Zofingen.
In the men's race, Felix Köhler for Germany took the lead in the first run, the age group world champion in the men 30 category from last year, followed by a big group with all the race favorites, but no defending champion Gael Le Bellec injured and not racing today. So bad news for France. No Gael Le Bellec, which means that Seppo Oden and Søren Bistrup are the big favorites for today. Yannick Cadalin was also in the group. We saw Andy Sutz back to racing together with Rolf Wermelinger and Fabian Zehnder and Pablo Martin for Spain in the chase pack. But we are looking at the two race leaders now in the women race after this short update. We will try to do it every hour to keep you posted on what's going on. With Nina Brenn and Emma Pooley, there they are on the General Gissonstrasse. It's the central point of the bike course. None of them has to go to the right hand side to the penalty box. There they are. After 2 hours and 4 minutes of racing, it's Nina Brenn in first place, followed by Emma Pooley. And look at the crowd, already a big crowd out today. Good to see so many people cheering on our athletes.
Wittmer als nächster Läufer hier bei uns vorbei, nach den ersten 5 Kilometern.
And if you hear some ambience here in the stadium, that's because the short course athletes are entering the arena after their first lap. It's a day packed with activity here in Zofingen.
Gestartet sind auf die ersten 10 Kilometer und bitte achten darauf, liebe Athleten, die Startnummer nach vorne zu tragen, die Startnummer auf den Bauch zu tragen. Also hier ein direktes Feld, schon bald bei uns, vor der Tribüne vorbei.
So after 50k on the bike, Nina Brenn, 2 hours, 4 minutes and 10 seconds, 3 seconds behind her at a comfortable distance. Emma Pooley, it's a non-drafting race, like I explained earlier. And to answer Ken Foster's question, when will other than the top 12 women be showing on the tracking map? Well, we only have 12 women. Now 11 with Julia Filet-Nergan on the tracking map. Tracking only available for the elite athletes. It's something new.
Der bei Blick auf Zofingen vom Heiten oben, also da wo wir schon bald anzutreffen sind.
And Chris Wright, enjoy your tea and biscuits. Great to see so many comments, so many people watching our live stream today. And yes, Damo Harris, we also will be cheering for Daniel Hopper. When we see him, we'll make sure that we notify you. He's in the open race, Daniel Hopper from Melbourne. It's great to see the athletes from the short distance now in the arena. The World Championships in Zofingen, long distance mean 10k run, 150k on the bike and 30k on the run. And that's the only race in the world which covers these distances. Where normal Powerman races are a 10k run, a 60k bike course, and another 10k on the run. And here we have the short distance with a 10k run, a 50k on the bike, and a 10k run, which is almost a normal Powerman race. But each year we're cheering on everybody on the long distance, and then yeah, the short distance, that's a bit of a side program for most of us here, but still impressive what the athletes are doing. And yes, Nate Peregrino, I have done a duathlon and some triathlons before. I must admit that I find racing in duathlon a lot harder than in triathlon, because the first run's an attack on your running legs, really explosive. While in the swim, it's totally different from running compared to between duathlon and triathlon. Most duathletes will confirm that. Goedemorgen, Thijs van Heij, overigens. We have a great view on the surroundings here in Zofingen. It's a great little city in the north of Switzerland with those typical old Swiss buildings. With a lot of great restaurants. But we're going back to the bike course right now with this Felix Köhler. He's still in the lead in the men race. The world champion from last year in the men 30 category. Was the fastest runner this morning. With a run of 30 minutes, 21 seconds. And now on the bike hill. He has a gap of 50 seconds to Andisutz. Yes, Andisutz in second place. But it seems to be a group of five in the pursuit with Yannick Cadalin, with Rolf Wermelinger, with Fabian Zehner and Pablo Martin Lopez. So five men in the chase pack behind this Felix Köhler, 50 seconds behind. Søren Bistrup already gained some time, has passed Thomas Bruns and Seppe Oden. Here we are looking at Susanna Svensson. Susanna Svensson together with Martina Kreembel, the two women in the pursuit, chasing our race leaders. Susanna Svensson in red for Denmark. In black, white and red is Martina Kreembel. The gap already 6 minutes 16 after one lap of 50k. What a race by Nina Brennan and Emma Pooley it is, because Susanna Svensson and Martina Kreembel are also very fast on the bike. 6 minutes. That's a big gap after 50k. But you never know what can happen suddenly in the last lap on the bike. Let's hope that they will stay on the bike, don't have technical problems or flat tires. All elements. Good morning to Krista Thompson also. So sorry to not see you this year in Zofingen. But I'm sure you will be cheering from a distance for Susanna Svensson and the other Danish athletes. And there she is, Katrine Ezeveld, looking good. 7 minutes 31 seconds behind the two race leaders in fifth place. All alone. So she's facing the competition of two duos in front of her. Fifth place, fünfte Platz für die Katrin Ezeveld. Rückstand 7 Minuten 31 für Katrin Ezeveld aus München. Susanne Svensson und Martina Kriembühl mit einem Rückstand von 6 Minuten 16 auf die zwei Mädels an die Spitze. Nina Brenn aus Flims-Waldhaus aus der Schweiz und Emma Poli aus Norwich, Großbritannien. And we have Katrin Götz now on the at the end of the first lap, or is that Miriam Varela? Looks to be Katrin Götz. Miriam is a bit bigger. Yeah, there she is, Katrin Götz. 8 minutes 39 seconds behind. Slowing down a bit to not miss. The nutrition great to see so many volunteers each year in Zofingen helping out on the run and the bike course and on everything else. This looks like Annette Corridon, and it is Annette Corridon is our age group race leader. Always a shame that she's not racing in the elite race. And then followed by Monique Grossrieder. 9 Minuten 40, die Rückstand für die Monique. Monique Grossrieder aus Düdingen. Crossrider in seventh place. And here comes Miriam Varela. Miriam Varela, achtste positie op 10 minuten 10. We hadden haar bij de favorieten gerekend. Er is nog wat werk aan het fietsen bij Miriam. Gekend als marathonloopster, maar ondertussen voor het tweede jaar zich meer en meer aan het toeleggen op duathlon. Miriam Varela voor de Netherlands. Renowned in her own country as a marathon runner, still has some work to do on the bike, but the last two seasons she's made a lot of progression in duathlon racing. Miriam Varela in 8th place, 10 minutes 10 seconds the gap on Nina Brenn and Emma Poli. Well, we're waiting for more women to pass the General Gisonstrasse. Let's look at the gaps in the men's race on the first bike hill. Maxim Kuzmin was in 10th place, and the Russian is doing good. 2 minutes 32 behind, he's accompanied by Thibaut Lucra. Daniel Formela in 12th place, 3 minutes 29 behind, and then Diego Van Looy, 13th, 4 minutes 55 behind. That's not what he was expecting, I guess. Let's see if he can recover and make his way into the top 10. Mark Widmer was in 14th place together with Diego. Also Thibaut Humbert and Michele Paone. That looks like quite a big group. with Rui Narigheta 5 minutes 26 back and Thomas Rusch at 5 minutes 54. But it's still Felix Köhler who is leading the men race. He's doing great, opened the gap of 50 seconds to Andy Sutz, Yannick Cadalin, Rolf Wermelinger, Fabian Zehnder and Pablo Martin. Nice cadence also from Felix Köhler. Looks like he has found the right gear. And thanks guys for all the comments. Merci ook, Sikke. And thank you, Stefan Weber, for the kind words. And yes, it will be an exciting race between the two leaders. Join us on the YouTube live stream through the powerman.ch website. There you will find all the information for the live stream, for the live athlete tracking, for the GPS tracking of the elite athletes. It's great to see Zofingen putting in so much effort to bring you up to date with all the action today, and it's been great so far. After 2 hours and 18 minutes of racing, that's for the elite women. The men's race started 1 hour later. Felix Köhler, who is passing the first women. That was a gap of 1 hour. First age group women passed by the race leader in the World Championships 2016. Deutschland. Der Mann aus Basel gewann die Swiss Duathlon Series dieses Jahr. Weltmeister im M30 Age Group Kategorie letztes Jahr. Und heute an die Spitze im Weltmeisterschaften im Elitefeld. Das ist schon großartig. Der Rückstand von 5 Männer, 50 Sekunden. In die Gruppe haben wir Andy Sütz, Rolf Wermelinger und Fabian Zehnder. Drei Athleten aus der Schweiz. Mit Yannick Cadalin für Frankreich und Pablo Martin für Spanien. Sören Bistrup, Thomas Brünz und Seppo Oden haben einen Rückstand von 1 Minute 40. So 1 minute 40 the gap for Bistrup, the Danish athlete, together with Thomas Brünz, the Dutch-Australian athlete. He was born in the Netherlands, but has been living most of his life in Australia. And always when we try to interview him, he always asks me not to do it in Dutch. So maybe we will try it again later today. Good morning also to Christy Lam. They have a big group listening in Texas, so good morning, Texas. Actually, it will be good afternoon, I guess, for the supporters from Texas. Yeah, swim voice coach would like to see the moto with our cameraman back to the chase group. We're covering both the women and the men race, so it's not always possible to have images of the chase pack, certainly not on this big course and cover it all live. We're doing what we can, and we will certainly see the chase group when they pass the General Guisson Straße. Felix Köhler, still looking good. Must be a great feeling also to pass the first women athletes. Gives you kind of a goal during the 50k on the bike when you're up front. Biking from athlete to athlete, maintaining his own pace. Okay, just heard that it's 2:23 a.m. in the morning. So yeah, good night, good morning, Texas. Women have passed the General Guisson Straße. Deborah Gesselen is now in ninth place. 13 minutes 49 the gap. With Bettina Steiger in 10th place, 15 minutes 10 seconds behind. And Airi Sawada, a Japanese lady, 20 minutes 21 seconds behind in 11th place. Now we have a view of the chase pack with Fabian Zehnder for Switzerland. Right in front of him, we have Rolf Wermelinger. It's Andy Sutz who is setting the pace. And Yannick Cadalin in second place. And it looks like Pablo Martin has dropped off at the first uphill part of this first bike lap. And we're still together with these four men. Great to see the Swiss athletes in the front of the race. It hasn't always been like that. Andy Sutz, of course, has been here before. We've had some great Swiss duathletes in the past, but the last few years, apart from Mark Widmer, who had a great race 2 years ago, we didn't always see them right up front. Some more internationals, but now it's the Swiss who are reigning in the Zofingen World Championships 2016. Großartig, drei Männer aus der Schweiz in der Chase Pack mit Yannick Cadalin für Frankreich. Hier haben wir Rolf Wermelinger. Und da gibt es Yannick Cadalin. Yannick Cadalin en deuxième position dans ce groupe de poursuivants pour la France. And also passing the age group women is Andy Sutz. He's setting the pace of the chase pack. Looks like he's really feeling confident today. It's great to see him back to racing. We have seen some big battles from Andy Sutz in the past with Yuri van Steeland, with Anthony Ledouet. Van Steeland, who has retired from racing, both duathlon and triathlon. And Anthony Ledouet, who has been racing a few elite races, but we also saw him in age group racing. Already 43 years old, but still very strong. But he has retired from racing Zofingen, not his favorite race. The two-time European champion, not with us this year. No Gael Le Bellec either. The reigning world champion injured. So we had to drop out of the race last minute. Felix Köhler nach 35 Kilometer auf die Radstrecke, immer an die Spitze. in der ersten Runde. 35 kilometers into the first bike lap with Felix Köhler, who is looking very strong. And look on the muscles on the legs of Felix Köhler. This is a tough part. The climb on the TT bike. Still sitting down, maintaining a good pace. Lower cadence though. And for me it looks to be a bit like a gear that's a bit too high for this climb, but we'll see. It depends of course on what type of athlete you are. Felix Köhler, our race leader. Last year he dropped to 7th place after the bike course, but then ran to gold medal in the men 30 category. Now in his first elite race. Der Felix Köhler immer an die Spitze. Er führt mit 50 Sekunden auf eine Gruppe auf. Andy Switz, Rolf Ermelinger und Fabian Zehner, Yannick Cadalin. Well, we saw the men passing the first age group women, and now we see the women passing the age group men. It's status quo. Nina Brenn still in front. Is she planning on taking the lead during 150k on the bike during the three laps? Emma Pooley still in second, 10-15 meters behind the Swiss duathlete. Brenn against Pooley. Will that be the battle for the rest of the day? It looks to be like it. The gap at the General Gissonstrasse was already more than 6 minutes to Susanna Svensson and Martina Krembühl. And great to see the both of them battling it out in the second bike lap. If you look closely, you see a bit of a higher frequency in the cadence of Emma Pooley compared with Nina Brenn. So a lower gear for Emma Pooley. Let's see later on which will be more efficient. And the European champion from Copenhagen He's looking great. Nina Ben in first place. Emma Pooley, the world champion from last year and from 2014. Can she make it three? Can we have a follow-up to Erika Sommer, our world record holder here? World record in number of gold medals in Zofingen. Erika Sommer, who has retired from duathlon racing and is only doing long-distance triathlon racing. She has promised to come back at the end of her career, but that's still not over yet. And we hope to see her back one day racing a final time in Zofingen.
Da seht ihr ein altbekanntes Bild, wir sehen Nina Brenn in der Führung und mit 15
Nina Brenn immer in die Führung mit Emma Poli. Zweiten Platz.
Die beiden Spitzendamen befinden sich am Fuße des Bodenbergs.
Am Fuße des Bodenbergs haben wir Angriff von Emma Pooley. Ein Angriff von Emma Pooley. Attack by Emma Pooley. At the foot of the Bodenberg. As she waited for this moment to place her attack. Overtaking Nina Brenn. And Brenn knows what time it is. It's time to pick up the pace and try to follow Emma Pooley. Halfway through the bike course. Here we will see it again. What a moment from Emma Pooley. Changing gears. And then up, off to the left-hand side of the road. What an attack. What a moment. Nina Brenn was just having a drink. Preparing for the upper section, and there you see it, Nina Brenn dropping off. Yeah, what an attack by Emma Pooley. Will this be the deciding attack of the 2016 Powerman ITU World Championships Duathlon? Nina Brenn, who has the advantage of some more freshness in the legs after her fall in May. She didn't have a lot of competition, but still has some back pains. But that didn't stop her. Last week when she won the Trans Vorarlberg Triathlon in Bregenz in Austria. Felix Köhler still looking great. Great to see a German athlete in front of the race. This is great for duathlon racing in Germany. The popularity of duathlon is increasing in Germany. Duathlon immer groß in Deutschland, aber dieses Jahr hatten wir zwei Powerman Races. Ulm war großartig für einige Wochen. Eine neue Powerman Strecke in Deutschland. Also gut, dass wir einen Duathlet aus Deutschland in Führung haben. Felix Köhler ist auf dem Weg zum Zofingen. In einigen Minuten erwarten wir Felix an die General Gisson Straße. And look at this footage from the Bodenberg. This is really, really tough. also 48 groupers racing here. And I can tell you, the first two times, it's still okay. But look at this, compared to the age groupers. Emma Pooley, all danseuse. Way to go from Emma. And where's Nina? That's not Nina, but one of our British age groupers. Yeah, that's quite a gap. What an attack by Emma Pooley.
Now we're waiting for Nina Brenn. They're already a couple of seconds gone. Oh, I see on the time monitor 1 minute. So Emma Pooley.
Already 1 minute at the timing point.
Kilometers on the uphill section. 1 minute between and Nina Brenn.
Eine Minute. Gibt es zwischen Emma Pooley im Führung und Nina Brenn. Da kommt sie.
Nina Brenn. Rungsthal erreicht. Ja, sie konnte diese Attacke von Emma Pooley nicht kontern. Aber hier schätzen sie als die stärkere.
And now it's time for Nina Brenn to find her pace. To avoid to explode. Trying to counterattack Emma Pooley. Well, Emma Pooley has seen Nina Brenn taking the lead all the time, but the second climb of the bottom barrack was enough for Emma Pooley. What an attack we saw. What a race. Felix Köhler, he has the view of the town center of Zofingen on the final descent, and then another few kilometers to go to the General Gisonstrasse, end of the first bike lap, where the crowd is awaiting him, or a big crowd is awaiting him. Conditions still great for racing today. It's a bit cloudy. Bit overcasted, but still warm, around 18-19 degrees. Weather forecast predicted temperatures of 26 degrees for today. Felix Köhler at the roundabout on his way to Zofingen. Still has to pass the train bridge and then coming towards us. And he's also looking strong on the bike, like he did on the first lap of the run course. Further timings from Susanna Svensson and Martina Krembul. The gap was already 6 minutes 16 after the first bike lap. Let's see how big the gap will be in the men's race, with Felix Köhler still in the lead. And the four men in the chase pack, who were 50 seconds behind him on the first hill. Felix Köhler, auf dem Weg zum Zofingen. Zum Ende. Die erste Runde auf die Fahrradstrecke. Sekunden war die Rückstand für die vier Erfolge. Andy Sütz, Rolf Wermelinger und Fabian Zehnder für der Schweiz und Yannick Gadalin aus Frankreich. In wenigen Minuten können wir gerade mal sehen, wie groß die Rückstand gibt am Ende. Erste Runde. Below the train bridge, close to the central station of Zofingen. We just passed Jenna Hay, US athlete. Is now almost at the General Gissonstrasse and is a roundabout. And then one more turn to the right, and then he's in the General Gissonstrasse. Here he comes, our race leader. End of the first bike lap, Felix Köhler. Daar is die spitze der Herren met Felix Köhler uit Duitsland, uit Basel. En de Schweiz, 1 Stunde 48 Minuten. Oh, en dan is er sneller dan de pace car. Faster than the pace car. En great skills. The pace car, who had to lower his speed because of one of the age group women right in front of it. But no problems there for our German race leader, Felix Köhler. 1 hour 48 minutes 54 seconds into the race. So a first bike lap of around 1 hour 16, 17 for Felix Köhler. Not bad at all. And he's opened up a bigger gap, where it was 50 seconds on the Boldenberg. While we're awaiting the chase pack, I think we see him coming through the curve right now. And was that one of the guys in the chase pack who stopped at the penalty box? It's a big group right now. The three Swiss with Rolf Wermelinger, Fabian Zehnder and Andy Sutz. Yannick Gadalin in blue for France, in red for Denmark, it's Søren Bistrup. In the light blue for Belgium, it's Seppe Oden. Thomas Bruns And here we have Martin, Pablo Martin for Spain. So a big chase back now. Seppel then overtaking Søren Bystrup. Ja. 1 Minute 47 die Rückstand, aber eine große Gruppe. 8 Athleten im Chase Pack. 8 Erfolge. Rolf Wermelinger, Fabian Zehnder und Andy Sütz für der Schweiz. Yannick Gadalin für Frankreich. Dann haben wir Søren Bystrup für Dänemark, Seppo Oden für Belgien, Thomas Bruns für die Niederlande und Pablo Martin. And here we see it again, the moment where the pace car had to slow down for one of the age group athletes, one of the Team GB athletes. But no problems, luckily for Felix. Let's hope that the pace car has already passed him again. And he's opening up a bigger gap right now. So we had four guys in the chase back, but Bystrup and Oden, just like last year, picking up the pace after the first bike lap. They did it last year as well. We had a halfway through the race, a big lead back of about 10 athletes. And Gael Lebelec proved to be the fastest runner out there. He saw some position switches a few times. The other men, Maxim Kuzmin, Thibaut Lecra, they were together on the Bodenberg. Susanna Svensson has just passed the top of the Bodenberg in fourth place. Martina Krembel was third, 7 minutes 39 seconds behind Emma Poli. So Krembel has a good race so far. Susanna Svensson now 9 minutes 46 seconds behind. So big gaps in the women race. Emma Poli, who dropped Nina Brenn. She was 1 minute behind. Here we see her, our race leader, Emma Poli. And this looks good. This is the Emma Poli from 2014, it looks like. Going a bit wide to avoid any risks in the downhill. Oh, she survived the Olympic bike course in Rio. There we saw a lot of problems, both in the women and the men race, in those tricky downhill sections here. No risks. She has a comfortable lead of over 1 minute to Nina Brenn, so she doesn't need to take any risks. Here we see Nina in second place, also looking strong. So, just like we said a few minutes ago, the goal for Nina Brenn is to find her own pace, not to try to overdo it and try to follow Emma Poli, but maintain a gap which is not too big still have a chance for the gold medal. She's a fast runner. We saw it in Copenhagen, where she was really strong in the second 10K, where we had a really exciting battle for the win and the gold medal in the European Championships. But this is Zofingen, that's something else. More than 300 people are watching our live stream. Join us on the YouTube page. Maxim Kuzmin has maintained his 10th place, 4 minutes 54 seconds behind our race leader Felix Köhler. Thibaut Lecra in 11th place, 5 minutes 2 seconds behind. And Sebastian Retzlaff has gained quite some places. He's leading a big chase pack of about 7-8 athletes, 7 minutes 9 seconds behind Felix Köhler. Nina Brenn in second place in the women race, when they passed the General Gisonstrasse again after the end of the second bike lap. We will have a view on the gap between those two leading ladies. So far we have seen some great tight racing by both of them, with the attack from Emma Pooley on the Bodenberg. The wind is picking up a bit, which will make it even more difficult for the women and the men. So it started out as a sunny, warm day. It's now a bit more clouded and windy, but still dry. And warm conditions here in Zofingen. And we have seen other conditions during the past few years here. Diego Valoy is also in the second chase pack, 7 minutes behind the race leaders. Sebastian Retzlaff, Michele Paone, Diego Valoy, Mark Widmer, Thibaut Humbert, Rui Nariketa, and Thomas Rusch, all in that chase pack. Pierluigi Senior in 19th place, 8 minutes 56 behind. And we have Mike Schifferle, 9 minutes 23 behind. Uli Bieler, 21st. And Daniel Formela has not passed yet. Could be that the Polish favorite is out of the race. We will try to confirm that for you. So first we lost Julia Filener in the women's race, and now Daniel Formela looks to be out of the race. So after 3 hours of racing in the women's race, let's give you another update on what we saw this morning. We had three leaders in the women race. Julia Fielener for Germany, Nina Brenn for Switzerland, and Emma Pulley for Great Britain. Here we see Nina in second place right now during the second bike lap. Nina Brenn, who got together with Emma Pulley at the end of the first run of 10K. Julia Fielener dropped off and exited the race. Looks like she was having an injury and had to quit. She was one of the race favorites, so really sorry to see Julia Fielener for Germany not longer with us. Emma Pulley and Nina Brenn came into the transition area together. Brenn had a fast transition and was the first out on the bike course. And after the second climb of the Boldenberg, we saw an attack from Emma Pulley, who gained a gap of 1 minute to this Nina Brenn, who is looking strong.
Richard Sloan, USA, Berkeley, and Thomas Sinter, Mr. Bauschmann,
Duisa. In the chase pack, we saw Martina Kreenbuhl and Susanne Svensson. But Kreenbuhl has dropped Susanne and is now in third place, 7 minutes 39 behind Emma Pulley. Susanne Svensson in fourth at 9 minutes 46. Here we are looking at live footage from the chase pack in the men race with Andy Sutz, who is being passed by Thomas Bruns. We have Rolf Wermelinger and here Fabian Zehnder in the chase pack. It's Thomas Bruns who is passing the Swiss athletes, maybe to answer an attack from one of the others. Yannick Cadalin still there. And then Martin. Looks like Sepp Oden and Søren Bistrup have chosen to attack. Felix Köhler was the first to enter the transition area in the men's race. He was faster than everybody else with a 30-minute run in the first 10K. And now on the 150K on the bike, three laps. Felix Köhler still in the lead. He passed General Gissonstrasse end of the first bike lap with a gap of 1 minute 47 seconds to a group of 8 in a chase pack. Rolf Wermelinger, Fabian Zehnder and Andy Sutz for Switzerland, Yannick Cadalin for France, Søren Bistrup for Denmark, Sepp Oden for Belgium, Thomas Bruns for the Netherlands and Pablo Martin for Spain. Just to get you up to speed with what's been happening in the first 3 hours of Powerman ITU World Championship Duathlon racing here in Zofingen. And what you hear right now are the finishers of our charity run. Always a very important part of the race here in Zofingen, with Natasha Badman, who just entered the stadium and crossed the finish line. Legendary triathlete and duathlete, Natasha Badman. Natasha Badman posing for pictures at the finish line. Great to see you here. Only running today.
Perfect. So you will come back to something next year for the long distance duathlon?
Maybe short.
Maybe short. That's pretty long as well.
My son is doing long today.
Oh wow! So good job, Warren. Let's cheer for your son as well today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Chris Slaufen und Tom Reis. Fabian Gratzen und Roy Ziegre.
Ja, ja, das ist eine Junge.
Nach uns auf Mitte.
Und dann Michael Gieseskoff, Ironman-Siegerin, Natascha Schamann. Wisst ihr, wie hast du schneller drin gefunden?
Es ist ein Sorge, es sind viele Erinnerungen.
So a lot of action going on here in Zofingen. More intermediate times in the women race, where we have Katrin Nesefeld in fifth place, 11 minutes 38, behind our race leader Emma Pulli. Miriam Vareje in seventh, 15 minutes 25, behind Monique Grossrieder in eighth, 15 38 the gap. Deborah Gijsselen in ninth place, 19 minutes 43 behind. And Bettina Steiger in 10th place, 23 minutes 6 seconds. That's the gap. Gaps are getting pretty big right now in this second bike lap. In the women race, we will be returning soon to live footage of the bike course and of the end of the bike lap here at the General Gietzonstrasse. We see once again the end of the first lap of our race leader a few minutes ago, passing the pace car. Whoop, to the left. Great biking skills by the German athletes. Felix Köhler, strong athlete, but he has to face the opposition. The competition of a big chase back here. The three athletes with Andy Sutz in second place. Rolf Wermelinger was right in front of him. Fabian Zinder, Yannick Cadalin for France, Søren Bistrup for Denmark, then Seppe Oden, Thomas Bruns, and Pablo Martin for Spain. And there you see the attack by Seppe Oden, trying to get rid of the other seven men in the chase pack. He knows he has to make his move towards the second climb of the Bodenberg. And then vice world champion last year in a tough battle with Søren Bistrup. So Seppe knows that he has to lose Søren Bistrup on the bike, because otherwise it will be tough in the last 30k on the run. You see some intermediate times after the first lap. Susanna Svensson and Martina Krembel were together. A gap of more than 6 minutes. The gap has opened up to 7 minutes 39 for Martina and 9.46 to Susanna. Katrin Ezefeld still in fifth place. And she's having a good race. And here we see Emma Pulli making her way through the age group field. Great racing by Emma Pulli. Emma Pulli in between cars. It's a traffic low course here. And now she has to pass the cars on the right-hand side. Oh, they're making way. It's good to see. Typical scenes from the bike course here in Zofingen.
Wunderbar, dann danke vielmals und ganz gute Rally.
Ja, all diese jungen Damen und Herren mit den schwarzen Shirts und den blauen Kappen, das sind alles Mitarbeiter der Jumbo AG, unseres Hauptsponsors. Wir wünschen euch heute alles hier unterstützt und
Emma Pulley looking great. After the first lap in the men's race, we had Felix Köhler in the lead. 1 minute 47 behind was that big chase pack with Rolf Wermelinger, Fabian Zehnder and Andy Sutz, the three Swiss athletes, all together with Søren Bistrup, Sepp Oden, Thomas Bruns and Pablo Martin. And then we have Maxim Kuzmin in 10th place, already 4 minutes 54 behind. So it looks like it's up to the first nine athletes to battle it out for the medal positions. Yes, Damo Harris, the road is open to traffic. It's low traffic. And athletes all had the briefing to stay on the right-hand side of the course so that it will be safe for all of them. In the meantime, it's getting crowded right in front of us. You can feel and hear the ambience here in the arena with all the finishers from the charity run, a yearly event in preparation of all the action that's going on later on today here in Zofingen. And so far we haven't seen any elite athletes turning to the left or to the right hand side. There is the penalty box. So it seems that so far no drafting penalties have been handed out. That's good to see. And our volunteers doing a great job in the nutrition area. Just saw Adrian Tiefenauer for Switzerland in the open race. Every time you see age group athletes who are not wearing their national team suits, those are competitors in the open Powerman race who are not, or who have not been qualifying for their own country, but still could enter the open category. That's what Powerman Racing is also all about. Not only for the elite top athletes, but also for every duathlete who wants to enjoy racing, running, and biking. That's what it's all about.
Also heute ist viel besser als letztes Jahr.
Hast du auch ein bisschen mehr trainiert?
Ja, natürlich auch ein bisschen mehr trainiert. Natürlich, Zofingen, Arbeit ist genau gleich. Und tolle Stimme, super Organisation. Warum nicht jede Arbeit dabei?
Felix Köhler.
Wir freuen uns in diesem Fall nächstes Jahr, dass Sie wieder dabei bist bei uns in Zofingen.
Sehr sicher, ja.
He's on his way to the Bodenberg for the second time. The gap was 1:47. See if he can keep up the pace or if the chase pack will get a bit closer now. Felix Köhler taking his time to drink and eat. Like I said a few times before, very important in long course racing. And he knows he's on his way to the Bodenberg, so not so much time there to eat and drink. Doing it now. We saw when Nina Bren was having a drink that Emma Pooley had her attack at the foot of the Bodenberg. That was the race moment of today so far. Maybe we'll get some more moments when you were watching last year or when you were here. You'll surely remember that other big race moment when our race leader Emma Pooley in the second lap on the off course part of the final lap on the run course was standing still, walking, cramps, pain. She still managed to run again and to cross the finish line in first place and to take home the win and the World Championship gold for the second year in a row. Felix Köhler, is he heading towards his first medal in the Elite World Championships? He already knows how it feels to become a world champion. Did it last year in the men 30 category. Er war Weltmeister letztes Jahr im Männer 30 Kategorie. Ein großartiger Erfolg für Felix Köhler. Und heute für den ersten Mal in Führung in Elite-Weltmeisterschaften Duathlon Langdistanz. Und auf dem Weg zum Bodenberg. So in a few moments we will be able to see how big the gap is and how strong Felix Köhler still is halfway through the race after almost 2 hours and 20 minutes of racing. We've seen some great racing here. We see Felix Köhler, he also has to make his way through the age group athletes athletes also who are on the short distance race looking behind them. That's not a good sign. We didn't see Emma Pooley looking behind her. She's been confident, but looks like Felix Köhler is maybe expecting some company soon. We saw the attack from Søren Bistrup and Seppo then after the first bike lap. So let's see. And uphill, it's getting crowded in this second lap with a lot of age groupers and short course athletes together on the Bodenberg. It will be a lot calmer in the final lap. And while we're waiting more images from the Bodenberg, we can tell you that Loïc Echardour is in first place in the age group race. No, sorry, let me correct that. It's Søren Otten in the men 20 category. He is in 17th place overall, leading the men 20 category. Loïc Echardour leading the men 30 category. Right behind him is Chris Roxburgh and Laurent Martineau, leader of the men 40 category, all in a big pack with Jan Meesmans also there. He's the race leader in the men 35 category, together with Pierluigi Senior. That's one of the elite athletes for Italy. Tibor Gesse, third in the men 30 category. Marcus Buchler, second in the men 35. And Jonas van der Vever, still first in the men 25 category. He had to let go of that big group of age group athletes racing together. But he has a nice gap of about 1 minute 40 seconds to Diederik de Rijck, who was second in the age group. Two Belgian athletes in first and second place. Dus goed om te horen voor de fans van Jonas van der Veveren. Hij op kop, de mannen 25. Op 1 minuut 40 van een grote groep waar ook Jan Meesmans bij zit. En Diederik de Rijck achter Jonas van der Veveren, tweede bij de mannen 25. Here we have Felix Köhler. Felix Köhler, immer aan die spitsen. Auf den Bodenberg. Für Deutschland. Aber auch ein bisschen für der Schweiz. Er lebt und wohnt in Basel, 30 Minuten von Zofingen. Und ja, Søren Bistrup, Rückstand 1 Minute 10. The gap has decreased to 1 minute and 10 seconds. So Søren Bistrup has gained 30 seconds together with Yannick Cadalin, Fabian Zinder, Rolf Wermelinger, Seppo Odijn, Pablo Martin, Andy Soets en Thomas Bruns. So the eight men in the chase pack still together. 1 minute and 10 seconds now behind Felix Köhler. This will be exciting to see. You can see the age groupers to the right having a tough day at the office. Same goes for Felix Köhler, but his speed is a bit higher. But it's a lot of work to pass them all. And of course he needs to maintain a distance of normally 3 meters wide when passing the athletes. Needs to do it in a few seconds, otherwise you could be penalized for what's called blocking. So once you start to overtake an athlete, you need to do it in the next 3 to 5 seconds to not get a penalty for blocking, but for the moment it seems like it's looking to be a very fair race. Andonsa's our leader. Felix Köhler. We just got the confirmation. Daniel Formella was walking around at the General Gisonstrasse at the end of the first bike lap, exited the World Championships. So one of my race favorites for the podium, no longer in the race. That's the second one today. Fellow German athlete Julia Vielehner for Germany. Well, we still look at Felix Köhler. Had also dropped out after the first run lap. We don't know what happened to Daniel Formella. He had a very good first run, but he is out of the race. She's still in the race. Nina Brenn, the Swiss hope for a medal this year in Zofingen. Natasha Badman has set a great example by winning the charity run. Let's see if Nina Brenn can have a great performance as well. She's on her way towards Zofingen, left at the roundabout, and then a few more kilometers to go to the General Gisonstrasse, end of the second bike lap, that is. Still in 10th place for Russia, Maxim Kuzmin having a great day, but a gap of already 6 minutes and 9 seconds. What a race by Nina Brenn. And we're waiting to see what the gap will be with Emma Pulli. Her big goal was to stay on the bike today. And in the first two laps, that seems to work. The reason why she has set that goal was, of course, her big fall that she had at the end of May. Lost a lot of competition rhythm then. Nina Brenn looking good on her way to the center of Zofingen. In the meantime, you can hear the finishers of the charity run cheering here, posing for the big group picture at the finish line of the Powerman Zofingen 2016.
Durch Zinnicker und Monika Zauber.
Happy birthday to Wouter Bellemans. One of the guys who's following us on the YouTube page. Feel free to comment on the race. Or you can also comment on our commentary and make it interactive. Tell us what you think about what's been going on all morning. We're 3 hours and 30 minutes into the Women World Championships Duathlon long distance ITU Powerman for the 9th time ITU World Championships here in Zofingen, for the 28th time Powerman Duathlon. And in a few minutes we can see how big the gap will be between Emma Pulli and Nina Brenn. Brenn, who is now near the train station bridge, which means in a few moments we will see her passing the General Gissonstrasse. Nina Brenn, auf dem Weg zum City Center in Zofingen. Nach rechts und dann auf General Gissonstrasse. Emma Pulli already passed the General Gissonstrasse in first place after 3 hours and 25 minutes of racing. And now we will have a look at the gap for Nina Brenn, who is now in the General Gissonstrasse in second place. Oh, 7 minutes 11 seconds. 7 minutes 11 seconds is the gap. Die Rückstand. 7 Minuten. Ja, das ist schon eine Überraschung, dass Emma Pulli heute 7 Minuten vor Nina Brenn ist. It's quite of a big surprise that Emma Pulli opened up a gap of 7 minutes 11 seconds to Nina Brenn. What a race by Emma Pulli so far. She's looking really strong. At the General Gissonstrasse. Oh, mechanical problem from Mr. Hathaway, the American age groupers. Luckily there is the bike mechanic tent at the end of each bike lap. Yeah, the local organization committee here in Zofingen works hard to make sure the athletes have the best day of their year of Duathlon racing. A good question from Damo Harris on our live stream YouTube page. He wonders how much running Pulli has in her legs with all the preparation for the games in Rio. 1 month ago, 14th in the time trial race, 54th in the road race, part of the Great Britain road cycling team in the Olympic Games. And that's only 1 month ago. So it's really a good question. The first run looked pretty good, together with Julia Fehlener in the beginning, and then staying close to Nina Brenn. Or maybe she didn't feel that comfortable with Nina Brenn running so fast. And maybe that's why she decided to set an attack in the second climb of the Bodenberg. Emma Pulli, who has opened up a gap of 7 minutes. Here's our race leader in the men's race, Felix Köhler, still in the lead. The gap has dropped to 1 minute and 10 seconds, so he's lost half a minute during this second bike lap. Still eight men in the chase pack, and when they maintain their distance of at least 10 meters in the no drafting zones, it's still an advantage to be in a group. You can set your pace looking at the riders in front of you. Another comment from Demo. If the lead keeps growing for Pulli, she won't have to run well. We've seen some surprising finishes here in Zofingen in the past, so even if the gap is very, very big, that doesn't mean that you can win it. We have seen some incredible performances in the past. Remember 2002 when Benny van Steeland was in the lead, had a comfortable lead, and then lost it in the last kilometer of the run course. He was completely exhausted, and he looked on his way to the World Championship, but it was only a second place then. So everything is possible here in Zofingen. Also for Felix Köhler, it is possible for a first-time elite athlete to win it. We've seen that before. He knows the course. He was world champion, Weltmeister, last year in the men 30 category. And Köhler looking strong on the, let's call it, the normal sections of the bike course. Uphill, he seemed to be struggling a bit, but I think that's just his way of climbing, choosing for a bigger gear, for a higher gear. Here is Martina Krembel in third place, having a great day, but 13 minutes behind Emma Pulli. 13 Minuten die Rückstand für die Martina. Martina Krembel aus der Schweiz. Eine großartige Leistung nach zwei Runden. Martina Krembel looking strong in third place. She dropped Susanna Svensson.
Felix Köhler from Germany. But now with a small lead than before on
and enjoy your meal, Daryl Brown. It's a roast dinner in Melbourne. People are watching from all over the world. We even have a group in Texas where looks to be staying up all night to watch all the action here in Zofingen. And I was informed that we are for the very first time live even in China today. 28 nations competing in these 2016 World Championships. From the Philippines to New Zealand. But up front, it's Great Britain in the women's race and Germany in the men's race. With Felix Köhler taking the lead. And Sandra Verlinde, enjoy your pasta. Prepared by Andy Sutz himself. Let's have a look at in the meantime, you hear the noise growing here behind me. That means that the first athletes on the short distance are entering the run course after their transition from the bike to the running shoes. Susanna Svensson in fourth place, hanging on there, 16 minutes 44 behind Emma Poli. And she maintains the same pace. Still some 3 minutes, a bit more than 3 minutes behind Martina Krembel. Seems that a lot of Australian supporters